Chichi Rodriguez, Puerto Rican. Bam! Motherfucker, Puerto Rican professional golfer. And all respect, dude, I don't think you never, ever have a professional black golfer.
I don't know about that.
Oh, come on now, Scootify. Next thing you know, you're gonna be talking about black president, too. Get the fuck out of here.
You better do whatever the fuck you gotta do to make sure you call Boss Man's money right.
Y'all need to apologize.
Fuck him.
Don't deal, right?
With all that shit talking y'all just did, y'all just woke up Boss Man's baby boy. Where your daddy at, boy?
He's taking a shower.
Let me ask you something. Do those pajamas hide the peace signs when you wet the bed?
Go on back in the bed before your daddy catch you while you're awake. Go on, go call him. Why you gonna say some dumb shit like that?
Mommy just needs to take her medicine. Hey, Daddy.
What's the flashlight for, Taz? I told you I ain't raising no punk.
I got the same dream again.
Well, it's just a dream, little man. Your mama loved you, you know that. Get some sleep.
Daddy. Do you kill people?
What made you ask that?
I got into a fight with Malcolm at school.
Did you get your ass kicked?
No, I beat him pretty bad.
Yeah. So what's the problem?
He gave me his lunch money and apologized, but some kids told me that my daddy was gonna kill his daddy.
Two things. One, doesn't look like you're gonna need lunch money tomorrow. And two, I'm not ever gonna lie to you. Now, I wouldn't kill somebody's daddy for a fight between two little kids. But if somebody took something from me, or hurt somebody that I loved, I mean, if somebody hurt you real bad, I wouldn't kill their daddy. I'd kill their whole family.
I love you, Daddy.
I love you too. Get some sleep. Guess what? One day, this is gonna be yours.
Who gave you these?
Woo! I'm digging this shit all day, son. Fucking A-Track, this is the motherfucking future right here, son.
Hey, Dooney, turn on the TV. The Lakers on.
Right, boss.
Walk away from the TV, Dooney.
Walk away from the fucking TV, man.
Norman, what?
I said walk away from the TV.
On.
Walk away. Uh-huh. Now walk back to it.
Come on.
Shut up, motherfucker. Walk back to it. You see that shit?
What?
Shut the fuck up.
Open your shirt. Shut the fuck up.
What the fuck, man?
Open your shirt and you better be quiet about it. Now, you're gonna tell him everything is cool.
Everything is cool, man.
So you gotta go to the bathroom. I'm going to the bathroom in a minute.
Take your fucking pants down.
Oh, come on.
Shut the fuck up and take your damn pants down now. Take these motherfuckers down, bro. Huh?
Come on, what the fuck, nigga?
Open your mouth.
Man, they were going to give me 25 years,
man. Open your motherfucking mouth. You fuck over your niggas, right?
Oh,
now,
suck
that shit like a good bitch. Suck, you like that shit? Get your bitch ass up. Come on, keep the shit in the mouth. Keep it in the mouth. Come on.
Are you okay, Okantuni?
I'm as far away from okay that I think you can get there, man.
How come?
I betrayed my friends, little man. They're gonna give me 25 years. They're gonna take me away from my family for a long time.
That's a lot of time, huh, Dad?
Yeah, that's a long time, son.
I think you did the right thing, Uncle Dooney, because I wouldn't want to be away from my dad that long.
Turn around and sit straight. Seen that?
Yeah.
See, that's what happens when you betray your friends. You're never to talk about this to anyone. You got it?
Okay. I love you, Daddy.
Yeah, I love you too.
My father's life. A drug dealer, a killer, and dead at 38. He left behind a son that loved him very much, and I did. He was my world. Despite what he did and who he was, I loved him as if he was a doctor, a fireman, a humanitarian, but he wasn't. He was, for the most part, one of those people that society could probably do without. Nevertheless, he was my father, my first example of what a man should be like. I watched people treat him like a god. So to me, he was a god. I feared him as much as I loved him, and I wanted to be just like him, and that's probably why I became a drug dealer. I tried to make sure my father's fate wasn't mine. Like most people in my line of work, I thought I was smarter than the game. I didn't play it like everyone else. Although I could afford to live anywhere, I chose to live somewhere upscale, but not too upscale, where my finances would be an issue. Nobody wanted to see someone too flashy in a conservative neighborhood. So to the people who lived around me and my family, I was Joe Ordinary. I lived what I considered the sucker's life, 9 to 5 till you die. But most importantly, I had a routine.
Good morning, Taz.
Morning, Greta.
Kiss my wife Amanda and our son, who I named after my father, Norman.
Don't forget we played the Tigers today.
6 o'clock.
Have I ever forgotten?
Taz.
Done. I'm there. Mwah. Bye, baby.
Bye.
I told everyone, including Amanda, I was the East Coast rep for a West Coast consulting firm. That way no one could ask to come by my job or see where I worked.
You know, Greta, you water that same spot every morning.
Mm-hmm.
Now this was my dope house. I just call it that because I would never have drugs of any kind here. I'm the boss, I leave that to the soldiers. I just call it that because it's where I do all my dirt. After Mom died, nobody wanted to let a known black drug dealer adopt a white orphan. But hey, cash is king. And after years of fighting with courts, I was his.
There you go again with that photo album.
When I got older, I realized that family is someone you end up with. You don't have a choice in the matter.
I swear, you look at that thing 100 times a week.
But what he did to make me his son was a choice, and it made me love him even more.
Baby.
You gotta be fucking kidding me. Hello? All right, I'll see you in a little bit.
Am I not on the fucking phone?
I'm taking your car.
No, you're not. I'm taking it. You can take the truck.
I don't feel like driving that big old thing.
You're the one who wanted an SUV with 20 TVs in it, not me. It's ghetto.
Oh, I know you're calling me ghetto.
I'm not saying you're ghetto. I'm saying driving around in an SUV with 20 TVs on and one person in it's ghetto.
But baby, isn't that what you say? The man makes the car, not the other way around, right? Are we saying that?
Huh? Yeah, you're learning. Yeah, the answer's still no.
As calm as I was playing it, what was about to happen would be huge. So huge it was sure to make me king of the avenue. I was getting ready to make a deal with the Mexicans. I'd start by getting my product wholesale, and that's about half. Only thing was, you better promise to buy a minimum every month, and come hell or high water, you better buy that minimum. But I wasn't worried. I was moving so much shit, I was already doubling minimum. And I had just hooked up with these bikers. See, they were white supremacists and would buy from me before my black and Latin peers. I used to think how my father would feel about me working with racists. But then I figured he would have told me to take their money first.
King of the Avenue for sure after this.
King?
Nah.
This is just about the money.
Fuck that. Your daddy was fucking king, man. It's your fucking birthright.
Yeah, look what happened to him. I'm not going out like that, man. I'm just getting my cake and I'm out. Then you could be king.
Fuck it. I'll be king after you. Shit. White folks don't want to see me living next to them acting like I'm a fucking consultant.
No, we don't.
You know what I'm saying?
Get a coffee.
I was playing it cool with Cal. Being the king was my birthright, and I wanted it more than anything, and I mean anything. I would do it or gladly die trying.
Pop, what the fuck?
You fucking backdooring my deal?
You shouldn't disturb what we got going on here. We already made the deal.
My deal? Hector, I thought we had an understanding.
You guys ain't my family. I don't give a fuck about you. All that cares about me getting my money. I don't care who I make the deal with.
Dunny Jr., son of the man my father killed for turning informant. Current king of the Ave.
The fuck were you thinking, white boy?
not supposed to buy from anybody but me. What's all the rules? You know it, motherfucker. The only reason you ain't sinking in a fucking dumpster right now is because Scooter Pie talked me out of it. The only reason I listen to him is because he's my general. And his son is your general. Otherwise, I would've come to your house and kill you myself. Tell you something, my boy. King of the Half was made for men like me. And as much as it kills me to say it, for men like your father, not like you. You never, ever gonna be king.
I suggest we go into my restaurant and have a couple margaritas, a couple tequilas.
King, baby! Who the fuck did you tell?
I didn't tell nobody.
Fuck!
What do you want to do?
Nothing. Let's go home.
We need to talk this shit out. We've seen Dooney Jr. kill for much less than this. Fuck that shit he was saying. The only reason he didn't try something is he didn't want to get Hector to crossfire.
Just go home, man.
Come on, man.
Go!
Motherfucker, Hector! Fuck!
Tez, you missed the game.
I know, I'm sorry. Work just got crazy. I gotta go to the West Coast.
When?
Now, I gotta go now.
The kids are all meeting for pizza. All right. Okay. You know, he didn't even let them clear the scoreboard until his daddy saw how good he did.
55-5, that's a good old-fashioned butt-whooping. Sorry, little man. Daddy will do pizza with you next time, okay?
Stop.
Here.
You know what? Do me a favor and just go out to dinner with your friends or something, all right?
Are you okay?
Yeah, I'm fine. I just need to think some shit out, all right?
Well, what about you, Bobby?
Jesus Christ, do you not fucking listen to me? I said go!
You have to be a fucking ass for killing me all the time.
Sorry.
Cal.
Yeah, what's up? Yeah, meet me at the spot tomorrow. Tell everyone to stay on alert. All right.
Oh, shit!
Kumeko Ambulatio.
Out of the frying pan.
Who are you?
Who do I appear to be? Yeah. I'm in.
What do you want from me?
A favor. And in return for that favor, I will deliver you right where you want to be. King of the Avenue.
For my soul?
We're overcrowded with souls. And we get thousands a day. Not to mention the billions we already have. Your one meager soul makes no difference either way.
But why?
Why you? You're one of my best workers. You're just providing a service. You're gonna get it from somewhere. Might as well be you, right?
I don't want this anymore. I'm done.
You know, Taz, sometimes we do too much to turn around. How do we know we've crossed that line? How do we know when it's too late for us? Call me conservative, but when I appear in your living room, as a rule of thumb, you can probably assume you've crossed that line.
Dunny Jr.'s king. He's the one doing your work. You need him.
The world sees Dunny Jr. as a common street thug. Only comfortable in the hood. He can't go to the places I need him to go. You're an all-American white male, blue-eyed to boot. That's all I need to put you where you need to be. So here's the deal, player. I'll do my bidding, and I will save your family from Dunny Jr. You've got no choice. Let's face it. He hates you. For what your father did to his. And he's been waiting for a reason. Dunny Jr. is plotting to kill your family as we speak. And once he's had his way with your precious Amanda, her summer dress pulled up, bent over your kitchen sink, backdooring her, he's gonna go to work on your little boy, little Norman. As he makes you watch. Now, if you decide to deal with me, I will meet you tomorrow at midnight at your father's final resting place. Now, if you're not there, I'll take that as a no and leave you alone.
Baby, what are you doing on the floor? Something told me to come home. Let's get you in bed.
Yeah.
I ain't giving a fuck, Scooter. He broke the rules. My father broke the rules, right? What happened? Huh? Taz's father killed him, right? 2 days before my fucking 10th birthday? How the fuck you think I felt every time my birthday rolled around? You don't have the wrong motherfucker to ask for forgiveness.
And I live by your father's life.
So you're not getting what I'm saying, man. It's a dumb fucking deal.
What are you talking about?
I already sent one of my boys to nail him.
You gotta have permission from the commission before you kill a boss.
I'm gonna find out where his girlfriend lives, where his son lives. They're gonna do him too.
Why the boy's family?
I'm not gonna make the same mistake his father did. See? Taz's son will grow up one day, man. And the only way to keep the weed from growing is to take it from the roots. And don't worry, man. I told him to make sure not to touch Cal. Let me ask you something, Scooter. What side are you on, man?
I'm on your side, boss, man.
I don't want to go.
Tina, it's too dangerous.
But I'd rather be in danger with you than safe without you.
Keys. Fine, go. Go clean up.
Yo, Pop's called.
Said Donnie Jr. put out the hit. We need to do something, man.
I thought I heard a scream.
Where do you live?
I live next door.
Right next door?
Hey.
Shit.
Okay, man. Okay. I didn't see anything, and I didn't hear anything. Okay.
Well, it appears as if we have a deal.
So what now?
You become the king.
You just wave your hands around and do some magic or something, what?
Do I look like a leprechaun to you?
Then what?
Open it.
What? Fuck that! Aren't you the devil? I mean, can't you just raise him out of there or something?
Contrary to popular belief, I don't just wave a magic wand. Different events have to take place for you to become this king. For those events to happen, I must bring forth a demon. This demon needs a host. And to show that this is your will, kind of like the signing of the proverbial contract, the host must be one of the people you love the most.
The only reason I'm doing this is to save my family.
I really don't care why you're doing it, as long as you're doing my will.
Thanks.
Signed your contract. I'll take it from here.
Hello.
Amanda.
Honey, you need to come home.
Why? What's wrong?
Baby, I don't know how to tell you this.
What happened?
The people from the cemetery called. Somebody dug up your father's grave and stole his remains. Did you hear what I just said?
Yeah. Oh my God, that's horrible. What did they say?
Don't worry about that right now. Can you please just come home? I'm really scared.
Okay. I gotta call you back.
Give me your hand.
What?
Now.
You need anything?
What?
Scooter probably gave me your stuff. I never got rid of it. You want something to eat?
I don't eat.
So, what do we do now, Pops?
My name is Deja.
Oh. Okay.
Let's get one thing clear. I don't give a fuck about you. I'm a demon straight from hell, sent to wreak havoc and do whatever is necessary to make you king of the avenue. So don't think just because I'm in this body that it somehow ties us emotionally. I'm here to do his will. And if commanded, I'll take you out and leave you on the field for dead. That's just what I do. And that's the story of you and me. Now go get dressed.
How'd you know about that?
I know everything you know. Papa Trump.
Yeah. Council meeting? I didn't know anything about a council meeting.
That's because it's about you.
Oh, so now I'm the motherfucking bad guy?
Dune, you know you can't put a hit on a boss without all us voting on it. Those are the rules.
Man, that motherfucker broke the rules first.
I agree with Dune.
You would.
What the fuck is that supposed to mean?
Nigga, it means Dune gives you your shit for a discount. So you gonna agree with anything he say. You his bitch.
Sonny, shut the fuck up. I sell my shit to whoever the fuck I want for whatever the price I want to. Anybody got a problem with that?
I don't blame Taz for doing what he did. Shit. You know you can't put a hit out on the boss without all us vote. Nigga gonna fuck around and starve to death dealing with you.
Motherfucker, I am the motherfucking king. Me. And the rules are, nobody can buy shit from nobody but me unless I say otherwise. I'll turn this motherfucker back into the Wild Wild West.
Dune, calm down. Calm down. We don't need to start a war. I think what we need to do is let Taz answer some of these accusations.
Motherfucker, of course you're gonna say that. You motherfucking white boys stick together.
Minchia, white boy, I'm Italian.
Same shit to me, a white boy that eats noodles.
I didn't come here to get disrespected.
Motherfucker, I'm the one that feels disrespected up in this bitch.
Yo, Dune.
Hey, come on, Dune. Just chill. I mean, nobody's disrespecting you, all right? Right, Eddie? Stanley?
I'm just saying what's on my mind. Ain't that why we had these meetings?
Thanks.
Let's just fucking vote, all right? Who's not in favor of the hit on Taz? And who's in favor of the hit?
Vote came to an end. That's it. This has his mind.
Prepare for a baptism. Now, who said your vote didn't count? Three things. One, this never happened. Two, Taz is now the new king of the Avenue. And three, y'all gonna get your shit for half price from now on.
I see. That's what the fuck I'm talking about.
It's not like we don't appreciate all this. But you just killed five.
Yo, watch your tone, motherfucker.
You just killed five bosses and the king. It's gonna be all out war out there on the streets.
I'ma handle the shit. Y'all just go about business as usual. And you remember, when a motherfucker's in a room, you just talk to the motherfucker. You don't yell at him. You got that?
Yes.
Say, I'm a bitch-ass nigga.
I'm a bitch-ass nigga.
At the time, I wasn't aware of what had just happened. Especially because the demon showed the same emotion as if he had just swatted a fly. But that was only the tip of the iceberg. There would have been an all-out war if the crews of the dead bosses woke up the next morning and found out what happened to their leaders. So for the crews of these bosses, waking up was not an option. That night, I drove the demon around as he massacred 28 of the most influential people in the game. Sometimes it's not how many you kill, it's who you kill. It was actually pretty easy for him. No one even knew there was a war. Everyone just had their guards down, so he just kind of picked them off like fish in a barrel.
A lot of people die every night.
Yeah, but you're not one of them.
Fancy police work.
You think this is a joke?
I think the joke is you guys are here at my door saying that you're here because I'm not dead.
Well, a lot of your constituents were murdered last night.
Constituents?
Yeah. You're a drug dealer, right?
Drug dealing's illegal in the state of Florida.
Where were you last night?
Where were you?
What?
Well, you're basically saying I'm a suspect because I'm alive. That would make you a suspect, too.
Where were you last night?
I know where he was. I came over last night. Twice, okay? I looked at this boy straight in the eyes, and I told him, turn the music down. He wouldn't turn the music down. He wouldn't listen to me. Okay, where you guys going? Hey, where you guys going, man? I told him what you wanted me to say. Please don't hurt me, please. Please.
We have to meet with the Mexicans.
28 bodies in one night. You had a busy night, and it shows. Man, that gotta be some kind of record.
I'm not impressed.
I don't know what you're talking about.
So I take it you're here for the same deal I gave Donnie Jr.?
Yeah, the deal that was supposed to be mine.
I don't trust him.
Hector, what's up with your boy, huh?
Danny was gonna get him tickets for a Heat's game.
Tell him I'll give him season tickets if he just shuts the fuck up, all right?
Taz?
Hector? I'm here to do business.
The deal's yours.
Good. Good. We'll be in touch.
Look, you taco-eating motherfuckers.
You wanna be chicken-eating motherfucker?
Well, I guess we all gonna be some chicken taco-eating motherfuckers. The old deal is off. The new deal is 10% less. With Dooney Jr. and other crews gone, we gonna be moving 40% more weight, making a lot more money. So pony up, motherfuckers.
Hi, guys. You order, please?
I guess we'll be having chicken tacos.
Fuck! Who is it?
Me, boy.
Come on, Pops, use your key.
Boy, I've been calling your ass like crazy. It's about Taz.
Baby, go take a shower.
Justice, or the biggest turf war in decades.
Where's Taz?
I talked to two of the other bosses, and they say Taz is the new King of Avenue.
In one night? Hold up, Pop. They're saying Taz did all this?
Jay, like this, they ain't speaking on it. But he's now the fucking top dog.
We top crew. Holy shit, he fucking did it. We top crew?
I gotta get dressed. I gotta go find Taz.
Good. Because I'm going with your ass.
All right, cool. Let me go throw some clothes on.
My boy. What's up? You the man.
How you pull that out? I'll show you in later, all right? Hey, Scooter.
Taz?
So, I gotta leave for a little while. I need you to run shit when I'm gone, okay?
Done deal.
Son, gotta talk to Taz for a minute.
About what?
Well, get your ass in the car.
Hey, Cal, give us a minute, all right?
All right. All right. We top crew.
What's up?
Did you do this?
I did what I had to do to protect my family.
I know. I need a job.
Done.
Taz. My son Cal, he's all I got. I'll do whatever I gotta do to make sure that he's safe. But you know, kids see everything. Even though we think they're not paying attention, they are. And shame on us for that. We tried to make you tough. I mean, we used to say, we ain't raising no punks. And with that, we gave our kids a front row seat to our world of death and destruction. And all I can ask of you is, if you need some bad shit to be handled, let me do it, man. This boy loves you, man. And he loves his life, and he ain't about to walk away, man. I'm gonna make damn sure that he's gonna be safe.
Okay.
Promise me.
I promise.
Now you go home, take your ass to bed, get some rest. Cause you look like shit on a stick, boss man.
The demon told me to go home for 30 days to let everything cool down. I told Cal the things I wanted him to do and that I was gonna be out of sight for a month. He didn't understand why, but Cal was my best friend, the absolute soldier. He didn't question too much of what I said. He just did it. Baby, I'm sorry I passed out last night without saying anything.
Well, no. You came in on Thursday night, passed out, and didn't say anything. It's now Saturday morning.
No shit.
Yeah, no shit. I just figured you're still upset about your father.
What do you mean?
About your father's remains.
How'd you know about that?
Taz, I'm the one that told you.
Oh, yeah.
Is everything okay?
No, baby, everything's fine. Can we just not talk about it right now, please?
Yeah, sure.
I'm gonna take a shower. Those 30 days were the best 30 days of my life. Being the king is what I thought I always wanted to be. Now that I had it, I'd have gladly given it all away just to relive those 30 days.
How long are you gonna be gone, Daddy?
It's a couple days, and I'll be back to my normal schedule.
But I don't want you to go.
Norman, stop crying.
Hey, I said stop crying, I ain't raising no punk.
Daddy? I won't be a punk anymore.
As I look in your eyes, the smell of your skin. Is Norman sleeping?
Yeah.
What's the matter?
He was crying because he didn't want me to leave. And I told him I wasn't raising no punk.
Taz.
That's what my dad used to say to me.
He knows you didn't mean it. Hey. Can I enjoy a glass of wine with my husband before he leaves? Norman's gonna be fine. Be strong, just like his daddy. Cheers.
Made more money in 1 month than we have in the past 6 months. This shit with the Mexicans is gonna set us forever. Everyone's scared of us, man. We a fucking powerhouse. Pops even said he ain't never seen a king more powerful. Shit, Taz, and everyone knows it. The fuck's wrong with you? You ain't said two words since you got in the car. You wanna get married, man? Have some kids? Where the fuck did that come from? Man, don't wish that shit on me. I mean, that's cool for you, because you're the boss man. But me, I'm a rider. You and Pop's the only family I want. That's it. After that, I don't give a fuck.
Change this radio station, man. Let's put on some white boy music.
Man, we just gotta go playing that white boy shit, man. Hip hop's where it's at, dog. Hip hop's dead.
To meet us here?
Yeah, it's for a meeting with the king. You know? It's like being the mayor. You gotta shake some hands and kiss some babies.
What's this? Everyone's here to show you respect. Welcome you as the new boss man.
Love you, motherfucker. We made it.
Taz. Been in the game a long time. I'ma tell you. It ain't never been this good. Appreciate it.
We appreciate it, Jim.
Of course. Congrats.
Now let's go party with these ladies.
I put my money over everything. I count my money with a month when the wedding rain. I'm sipping good while I'm chilling here with Mary Jane. My head high, nuts big, and I let them hang. I'm getting paid. See, I walk in the club and everybody know my name.
Watch out.
What the fuck you say to me?
You heard what I said. Get the fuck out of my way.
Fuck you, nigga.
Hey, what do you want to do? You want to die to
hey, 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 what? Hey, you, hey, hey. Relax. Hey, man. Who are you? Who are you with?
You don't know who I am, man? They call me Homicide, boss, man. And if he with you, then I apologize.
Well, he is. Relax.
And I apologize, man, for that reason. For that reason only. Believe that.
Yeah, keep smiling.
Bitch.
We gonna talk later.
All right, you definitely
your
will.
Bitch ass.
What's wrong with you, man? Let that shit go. Come on, man.
Fuck that nigga.
You see, gangsters? Gangsters? They go to jail. Time of the street thug? That shit's over, man. It's dead. You will never, ever see anyone from my crew wearing saggy pants and the oversized shirt. The only thing missing are floppy shoes and the red nose. Fucking clowns. See, this is a business, all right? Like the military uses camouflage to blend into their surroundings, our camouflage are suits, conducting ourselves like gentlemen, keeping the violence to an absolute minimum, Cal. I'm watching you, homie.
Preach on.
Apply these principles to your operation. I guarantee you, the era of prosperity will be here for years to come. Hear ye, motherfuckers. Drink up.
I put my money over everything. I count my money with a muff when it went rain. I'm sipping good while I'm chilling here with Mary Jane. My head high, nuts big, and I let them hang. I'm getting paid. See, I walk in the club and everybody know my name. See, I been on the grind. Come take a look at what I made. Money talking, I ain't saying nothing. If you ain't talking about money, then I ain't saying nothing. Hey, hey.
Man, mm-hmm. Pour my man some more drink.
Okay, Papi.
Thank you, sweetheart. Mm-hmm. Everything that we've been dreaming about.
I'm telling you about that. Who's going with their drink?
Back up, you're gonna drop the
bottle. What you mean? Hey, who drink Cal? Is it?
Hey, I let this shit go once.
You want a drink? Go
what's
to
up, nigga? What's up, nigga?
Yo,
how
what
you doing?
Fuck you, nigga.
The fuck I tell you, motherfucker?
Yo, excuse me.
Yo, somebody come get this motherfucker out of my party, man. The fuck are you doing?
Bitch ass!
Yeah, look at you now.
What's wrong with you, youngster?
Stupid ass motherfucker.
I'm not bragging. I'm a fucking dragon. They don't wanna fuck with me. I got my nine in this bitch with me. Now they about to feel a nigga's fury. Motherfuckers. Gotta kill me somebody tonight. It's a fucking game.
What'd you do?
the fuck would you kill this nigga at my party and bring this heat to me?
I told you 3 motherfucking times, nigga. I didn't do it.
But you know what, Cal? You want to deal with this shit.
What the fuck I need to deal with it?
You broke the bottle over his head.
He was a bitch!
Well, take this bitch to the swamps.
Fuck!
Go ahead, handle it, Cal. We appreciate your hospitality. We'll get this cleaned up, all right?
Thanks a lot, boss, man.
Yeah, I'll do it to keep the peace. But this shit is fucked up.
I'll do it. Just help me get him in the back seat, man.
After that little glitch, things went exactly according to plan. Making money hand over fist. We had everything we wanted. Money, houses, cars, and the women. Oh, the women would do anything just to be in our world. We were young, rich, and unstoppable. Since Cal was running the business so well, I started spending less and less time in the hood and more time with my family. It got to the point where I hardly even seen the demon anymore.
Oh, look, my mom collects these.
These are cool, Mommy.
Yeah, look.
Look, Daddy. Wow.
Norman, put it back.
I'm gonna get Daddy. Wow.
Stop it, okay? Just take that off. Might rip it or something. Sorry.
Can we go see the motorcycles?
Yeah, go ahead. I'm gonna stay here. Taz, be nice.
Whoa, cool. No, you can never have one of these, son.
Oh shit, it's the king.
Is this your motorcycle?
That's right, little brother. It's my motorcycle.
It's a pleasure having the king's son on my bike.
Dad, what are you a king of?
Hey, the streets haven't been the same since you've taken over, my brother. It's definitely a pleasure.
Come on, let's go.
That's your lady, too?
You don't know me, all right? You made a mistake, okay?
Yeah, you got that. You got that. You're the king.
Come on, let's go, son.
What was that about?
He thought he knew me. That's...
Well, then why did
that's
you...
That's all.
What's up, Cal?
Shit. We made the streets flourish like this. We paid you every fucking month. And now you want more money? You might as well put a gun to our head.
I'd rather not to.
Well, if it's on, it's on.
Cal, let me talk to Hector.
Your boy needs to learn some respect.
Maybe. But like me, he said we had a deal.
Taz, Taz, Taz. You take care of your people well. That makes them respect you, love you. That is something that's gonna keep you on top for a long time. If I allow it. I made you. I can make Frank, Eddie, or Stanley. You might be the king of the avenue. But I am the king of the fucking world.
What happened?
It's done.
And you're good with this?
No, but fuck it. That's the way it is, all right? 25% more, whatever. We're still getting 4 times as much as we were before, right? Hey, trust me. This is how you keep the peace, all right?
Fuck that!
It's done, Cal! It's fucking done. Just let me worry about that, all right?
Whatever you say, Taz.
Come on, that's not even a problem. Listen, you've been keeping all of our bellies full. It'll be my pleasure. Yeah, I know the little restaurant. The one on Collins Street? Through the kitchen. Okay, through the kitchen. Then I'll see you there. Perfect. All right.
Come back to bed for a little while.
I can't, I gotta go.
can't seem to get enough of you. It's not my fault. Stop being so adorable.
You know what? You always find a way to distract me from my work.
That's good every now and then.
Some might think otherwise. Let's go have a quickie.
Whoa, whoa, Stan, what the fuck are you doing?
You ain't gotta put deli cuts in my face or poison me. Fuck all that craziness. You put one right between my eyes.
Calm down. What's the matter with you, Stanley? Coming to my house waving a fucking gun around, talking about killing, man. What happened?
He sliced his whole face up, man. Peeled the skin right off. And Frankie, poison. He tried to tear his own tongue out his fucking mouth. It's some straight evil shit, Taz. I think our sins finally caught up to us.
Man, pull yourself together, all right? I don't want Tia to hear this shit. Why did you do that? Why do you gotta kill everybody? It was good, man. No one was a threat. You killed Eddie and Frank, didn't you?
Hector said you weren't the only game in town. I bet you are now. Get rid of the body.
Cal, shit's out of control, man.
You motherfucking right it is. Hector killed Eddie and Frank. Nobody knows where Stanley is, and that leaves you. And nothing's gonna happen to you.
No, 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 it wasn't them, man.
They're killing our people, man. The peace is over.
What?
Taz, you're getting too fucking soft. I've been running this shit.
Cal, listen to me very carefully.
Not this time, boss man.
No, I'm not asking you, motherfucker, I'm telling you. What? Hello?
Fuck!
What are you doing?
When I was a kid, I thought you were the best thing that could have happened to me.
I told you I'm not your father.
No, fuck you! You're gonna listen to me! I loved you so much. I was your little boy. Everything I learned about what's right and wrong, you taught me.
Mm-hmm.
Getting in this life, I knew exactly what I was doing. Maybe if it had a better start, it could have had a better conclusion. Now I gotta go stop Cal.
You still don't understand, do you? You made a deal with the devil. The most evil entity known to God or man. You can't just turn that shit off. The floodgates of hell are open. So whether I'm with you or not, I still have to do his will. Nothing. Nothing will jeopardize you becoming king of the avenue.
Cal's about to fuck up. And everyone that fucks up, you kill. Uh-huh. Not Cal. That's my heart.
Uh-huh.
Get the fuck out of my way.
No.
I got no problem putting an end to this nightmare right now. This should definitely jeopardize me being king of the Ave, huh?
I don't see Taz. That's not a good sign.
Where's Hector? Is he in a truck?
Don't worry about that. Yeah, make him talk.
Is he in the fucking truck?
No, he's not.
Yeah?
Yeah.
I think he is. Go! Go! Park it out on third. Kill everything you see!
I fucking told you! Let's get the fuck out of here.
Oh, I gotta burn him up first.
What? Pops, we gotta go.
You fucked around and let him grab your arm. You got too close to him. Now you got hair particles and shit all over you. Those forensic dicks are gonna find that shit.
What do I do?
Here, take the fucking gun and go to the fucking car. Shit.
Pops is crazy. He's back there burning up the body.
Body? What'd you do?
I smoked the loudmouth. You told me Hector wasn't in the truck, but I knew he was.
No, no, you fucked up, man.
Man, they killed
him. Cal! It wasn't them.
You killed all those bosses. And everything just fell into place. That was brilliant, Taz. I just wanted to do like you did.
We gotta go.
Wing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me home. Swing low, sweet chariot, coming for to carry me
going, motherfucker.
You're not real.
I'm real enough to make you kill. Mm-hmm. I made you kill Eddie. How about Frankie? Stanley, who, by the way, is still in the trunk. And then there's your boy, Cal. Oh, yeah. Devil bless him. He really loved you. How about poor little Tia? Oh, you don't remember that, huh? Yeah, all that little girl wanted to do was love you. I make you see what I want you to see. And I make you do. When you have the audacity to say I'm not real, I'm as real as it gets. Your whole damn life is one big tragedy. Son, you dysfunctional. You had to create a motherfucker like me to protect you. Just like your daddy said.
I told you I ain't raising no punk.
It's all.
Yeah, and a punk is exactly what you became. Until I came along. Until Deja came along. Then nobody fucked with Taz. Yeah, you kept me hidden all these years, but then I had to come out.
Get out of my fucking head!
I'm your daddy. I'm just fucking with you. And I'm always going with people. I like to fuck with people. So I'm always going to fuck with you.
Hey,
okay? Dad!
Amanda, baby! Baby!
Oh my God!
I killed everybody! It was me! I fucked up!
What are you talking about?
You gotta get out of here, baby. He's gonna kill you too.
Who? Who are you talking about?
My dad. He came back as a demon or me. I don't fucking know.
Taz, your dad is dead. You're just upset because somebody...
That was me!
Taz, you're really scaring me. And you're covered in blood.
Not my blood. It's Cal's. He made me kill Cal.
Daddy!
Don't let him see me like this, baby. You can't let him see me like this.
Stay inside! Go up to your room! It's okay, baby. Mommy and Daddy are just talking. Whatever's going on, I can help you.
Baby, listen to me. You gotta get Norman and get the fuck out of here, okay?
Why? Dad, I love you, and I'm not going anywhere until you tell me why!
Baby. I'm a drug dealer. One of the biggest drug dealers on the Florida coast. And I killed people. A lot of people. And 30 miles from here, I got another house with a girlfriend named Tia. Killed her too. And I was the one that dug up my dad's remains. And that's the dead body of one of my drug lords in the trunk of my car. And baby, the demon in my head, he makes me do things. So listen to me. Get Norman and get the fuck out of here now, okay? Go.
Now what the fuck did you do that for? You told her everything. Now you have to kill her and your son.
No.
You have to. She knows everything.
Fuck you.
No, fuck you. It's not my fault you told her everything. Now I'm gonna give you an option. You can go in there, put one in the back of their heads painless, or you know how I put in work. Swing low, sweet chariot.
You're not gonna hurt them.
Coming forward to carry me home.
Amanda, go!
Fuck!
No! No!
Coming forward to carry me home.
Let's go, baby.
Swing low, sweet chariot. Coming forward to carry me home.
Now my son will grow up without a father. Without the proper guidance. He'll always wonder, what if my dad was here? Sure, one day Amanda will find someone else. She's a good woman, so she'll probably find a good man. And they'll raise my son without me. But I know nobody will ever love them like I did. And under different circumstances, we could have been so happy. But I guess we'll never know the answer to that. Because I wasn't strong enough to break the cycle. Are you?
I've got to do. So I gotta tell you, I've been waiting for the day. Say you hear what I'm saying. I need you in every way. Oh, baby, baby, baby. Say you understand what I feel inside. Let me be your everything tonight. Let me be your everything.